Know 8 characteristics of a scholar. Your producer, it's me, Chuck Zod. One day Socrates switched the bourbon during afternoon and went with it to the market. Many people wondered at him and laughed at him, but few of them asked him, why did he do that while it's afternoon? Socrates answered, while we see the sun, still people's minds are still in darkness. So he decided to light them up so that they may use their mind to find correct answers about the challenges facing them. Right here, Socrates targeted scholars. So right now, who is a scholar? Think of yourself if you're really a scholar or a savage. Number one, a scholar is a researcher and not an expert. A scholar loves questioning everything for the sake of making it better and not extincting. He's not brainwashed. A scholar believes questioning makes things be perfect. Questioning is not betrayal or catalyst. Questioning is the right thing for your mind. When you look at a lot of discussions from social media till to the streets, you will realize we have a lot of savages and few scholars. Instead of discussing, people discuss people and ending up disrespecting each other. A scholar discusses using brain, while a savage discusses using emotion and end up knocking face to face. A scholar has patience, has no rush, because the good thing of life is to have the patience in your heart. A patient heart will give you a gap for questioning before you answer the problem existing. Opening everything is patience. You will get a duck by an egg scratch and not by breaking an egg. The most important thing is, we should not stop questioning. That was stated by Albert Einstein. By questioning many things, I've been open who ask a lot. We'll learn a lot and remaining with many too. Asking is not stupidity. The vocabulary of why, which is primarily for asking and researching, is rapidly decreasing in our society. A scholar, you are supposed to even ask your own decisions. A scholar questions before making decisions and not after deciding. Einstein said, the most important thing is we should not stop researching. Researching is getting a clear picture in your mind before doing it. Research is like a factory in mind, that was stated by Jackie Youngblood. While a scholar asks before taking action. Savages take action first and therefore questions. They give out answers first before knowing the questions. Giving out answers before knowing the question is the same as sharpening a knife with your own tongue. The results will surprise you. The biggest sin done all in the world is giving out answers for life without having correct questions about life. Therefore, it's like having luck in life. Remember, life is not a jackpot, it's being correct. Number two, a scholar is a person who walks around to learn. A scholar is a person who takes a long journey to learn. To a scholar, journey is very important. There's no scholar who spends money on vacation. It's a must he spends a vacation changing the environment he lives in and not relaxing. In a budget of a scholar, a journey can't miss, like the way how alcohol is to an alcoholic person. Walk and see. Don't wait and be told the world does too much. Walking makes you more open-minded. Walking makes you erase uncomfortableness too. Walking makes you to stop the behavior of doing things by getting used to them. Walking makes you let go of ignorance by being so perfect about everything. A scholar doesn't travel to look dull, he travels to learn seriously. A scholar who even travels abroad to come back with full experience is the best, but not by having leisures and drinking, but he questions and learns how to create his own staff at home. A person with full experience by traveling different places has a big scope because meeting with different people. Walking is a big experience. Russians say, it's better you see for yourself once, rather than hearing about it 100 times. Seeing is better than being told. You may say you see through television, But the truth is, through television, you can't ask anything. Ever since you started your job till your retirement, you have never taken a walk and still call yourself a scholar. You teach about Mount Everest, but you have never seen that mountain. So he calls himself a scholar. You have never walked out of your employed station and self-employed till you grow old. Therefore, you can't have different thoughts. Walk and see. Being taught by someone is not good. Scholarship is not separating yourself with the society. Scholarship is mixing yourself with the society. But how will you mix yourself up while you don't take a walk? Number 3. A scholar is someone who keeps learning, because education has no end after graduate. A scholar keeps learning different things, like reading books. He doesn't read because of certificate. He reads different books so as to have more skills. It's not a must for a person to attend class to learn finance, so as to know the financial situation of the country. A scholar knows this by reading books. You call yourself a scholar while you even don't know how is your country growing rapidly financially. A scholar follows up more information about life outside the class. A scholar who doesn't know how politics of his country going on, because he has believed politics is a dirty game. He is so embarrassing. The quench of a scholar is knowing more even when he is in the journey. You will find him with books and newspapers, and not ice creams or snacks. A true scholar doesn't agree to lag behind like a pig's tail. A scholar reads big percentage of books, like 3 per month. What about you? How many books do you read? To a scholar, not reading books is uncivilization. When you don't read books, you lag behind. To a scholar, lagging behind is a shame. Number 4. A scholar accepts to be criticized by people, because the only perfect is God. A scholar who gets criticized doesn't get mad or insult others. Instead, he accepts to be criticized. When you disagree to be criticized, it's strange. Through criticism makes you more skillful. A scholar believes it's responsibility of everyone to get criticized. There is no good without wrong. Making mistake is humanity, but correcting where I did wrong makes your humanity look more meaningful. Denying criticism makes you look down. God's work is the perfect. Let's criticize to correct one another. Let's do good for our own world. Let's not criticize each other for the sake of setting or extinction. Criticism makes a good way of conducting. Number 5. A scholar protects his tongue well, because it's his strength. A tongue has no bone, but it bites more than teeth. A tongue is a very small organ, but it has done a lot. Many use tongue to kill. Tongue has made a lot of families separate and lead to the lives of 2 children. Tongue has made people to commit suicide. Many conflicts happen because of tongue. A scholar doesn't backbite, he warns. A scholar doesn't do catalyst, he reconciles. The tongue of a scholar doesn't announce stupidity, it announces skills. A scholar meditates a lot, because the work of the brain is to meditate. A scholar is a true speaker forever. Intrigue to him is no. No matter how a scholar has challenges, he will never ignore the truth. He knows the path of a lie is short. Truth doesn't mix up with lies and remains the truth forever. Number 6. A scholar is a smart working person and always stay positive about development. A scholar can't get successful within a day, because getting development within a day is a stupid thinking to savages, because it makes people become tempted and lack patriotism. A scholar believes depending on ideas creates poverty, because the one who depends on others die poor. Development comes by working hard and skills, and not hard work itself. Hard workers die poor, smart workers die rich. A scholar hates bribe a lot. Laziness has a habit of getting rich without working. Generally, he ain't a thief. He doesn't give or receive bribe. A scholar believes doing this is foolishness. He believes development comes by competing. A scholar works out by taking action and not by mouth. The world of these days doesn't need too much talking. A scholar doesn't have the word impossible in his vocabulary. Impossible is a vocabulary to fools who leave everything to God instead of walking the way how God blessed them with. To the poor is love of God. Laziness promotes poverty and hunger. A lazy person is a slave to a hard-working person. There is no scholar who agrees to be a slave. Number 7. A scholar is a person who respects time because time is money. The truth is, you can't separate success with time if you need to see success. It's a must to respect time. A vocabulary of saying let's go, we waste time doesn't exist in a dictionary of a scholar. Both successful people and unsuccessful people have 24 hours. The poor and the rich both have the same hours. The difference is the way we use time. The difference is the one who uses time to hustle, while the other ones uses time to blame and complain the results of it, it's different. The one who waits time to complain is a must time to scream up. The one who keeps time to hustle, it's a must time will keep him alive. Success is a must, even though you don't want it. All success under the sun, its importance, its discipline of time. When you play with time in your youth, you will disturb your children during old age. Years run too fast. Today you are young. Tomorrow you are old. A scholar knows all these secrets. The one who goes different from this is not a scholar, but a fool. This world doesn't belong to your daddy. If you mess with it, it will swallow you. Number 8. A scholar is a person who brings solution to problems facing a society. A scholar is a person who uses his education to bring hope to a society. A scholar is an image to the society. He makes his life better together with the society too. He solves problems facing in his society, surrounding him. He doesn't live by acting. You can't be called a scholar if you're afraid to live with the society. You can't be called a scholar if you have a conflict with your wife. You can't be a scholar if you're fighting with your husband every day. And anyways, your producer, it's me, Jack Zod. Follow me on Instagram at Jack Zod, Facebook, Jackson Moisemba. Thanks for listening.